Hello guys, Zanrish and welcome back to a new video. In this video, I'm going to compare the Realme X7 Pro against the Mi 10T. Both these devices are flagship devices by Realme and Xiaomi respectively. If you were confused whether to go with this one or this one, then I hope this video will help you solve that confusion without wasting any time. Let's get started. First of all, let's talk about the build quality and looks. Frankly speaking, the black color that I have of the Realme X7 Pro does not look great, and even the Mi 10T's back panel is not fancy. I mean, I would rather say that Mi 10i's back panel, which is available for 20,000 rupees, is way better. Realme 7 Pro, the older Realme X2 Pro, or even the X50 Pro had better back panels as compared to Realme X7 Pro. Both these devices are fingerprint magnet, so use a case if possible. But when it comes to weight and bulkiness, Mi 10T is much bulkier, much heavier as compared to the Realme X7 Pro. If you hold these devices at the same time, then you feel that Realme X7 Pro is lighter, obviously. Not just that, but it feels better to hold in hand, and one-handed usage is easier, I feel, on the Realme X7 Pro as compared to the Mi 10T. Now, if you have bigger hands, Mi 10T will not create any issue, but if you have smaller hands, then there is no way I can recommend the Mi 10T. And I said this in my full review of Mi 10T as well. Realme X7 Pro is the device to go for then. If you have medium sized hands, then Mi 10T will take about 3 to 4 days to get used to it. It's not like you can't get used to it. But the camera bump on the Mi 10T once again is huge as compared to Realme X7 Pro. Realme X7 Pro's camera bump is almost non-existent. It's there, but it's not that huge as compared to Mi 10T. Next up, let's talk about the processor, RAM, performance. And this is where things are interesting. Mi 10T comes with Snapdragon 865 processor, and Snapdragon 865 processor is a very popular one. It's by Qualcomm, obviously. It's a flagship processor, large generation though, but still, it's a flagship processor. Dimensity 1000 Plus, also flagship processor by MediaTek, and both these processors are comparable. I did not do a speed test comparison of Mi 10T against the Realme X7 Pro, but I can say that in day-to-day life usage, I found that both these devices were very fast, and opening applications, closing them, multitasking between them was very easy. I have the 8GB RAM variant of Realme X7 Pro and 6GB RAM variant of the Mi 10T, so that's why I did not do a speed test comparison between both of them. But let's go ahead and let's try our regular extraction test. Let's click on extract at the same time and let's see which one completes the extraction test faster. When I did the comparison against the OnePlus 8T, Realme X7 Pro was faster, and this time I guess Mi 10T is going to complete the extraction test faster. I guess it was OnePlus's Android 11 what that was creating an issue. Then we have another thing, KineMaster application. We'll see which one can render the video fastest. So we are going to select 1080p 30fps video. The resolution is same. 768MB file will be created. Let's click on export, and now let's see which one completes this particular test faster. Now, these speed tests usually, like when you open the app side by side, do not really mean a lot. The minor millisecond difference that's going to be there between, let's say, one flagship device to another flagship device, which is Realme X7 Pro and the Mi 10T, won't really matter that much. It matters only when the software optimization issue is there. But even if MIUI 12 or 12.5 does not perform really good on the Mi 10T, the thing is, Snapdragon 865 processor is powerful, and that will be the saving grace for MIUI. But as you can see in the export test as well, Mi 10T is much ahead as compared to Realme X7 Pro. I know you will be surprised, and I will be too, because when we did this particular speed test comparison against the OnePlus 8 Pro, Realme X7 Pro and OnePlus 8 Pro were very close to each other, whereas Mi 10T has won by a huge margin, as you can see. So right now, with Android 10 and the current MIUI version that I have on the Mi 10T, it definitely performs really good. And if we talk about, as I said earlier, opening applications is really good on both these devices almost at the same time. Sometimes Realme X7 Pro opens applications faster, sometimes Mi 10T does it faster. So when it comes to the raw CPU performance, like video rendering and extraction test, you can clearly see that Mi 10T is the winner as compared to Realme X7 Pro. Dimensity 1000 Plus processor is not a bad processor. It's just that current version of MIUI that I have installed, or the latest update, obviously both these devices are on the latest updates, is really good. Even if MIUI's optimization reduces a bit in future with updates, because that's what has happened with other devices like Poco F1 or Redmi Note 7 or 8 series of devices, you do not have to worry about it on a flagship device as such, because it's a flagship processor and it will perform really good no matter what. And I guess that's going to be my expectation. And as we are talking about hardware and performance, let's talk about UIs. Realme UI against the Mi UI on the Mi 10T. Once again, Realme UI is going to be my personal choice, my personal pick against Mi UI. Mi UI was one of my favorites, but the ad situation, the apps being there, like a lot of apps being there, but Mi 10T is not really in that category because you do not get a lot of pre-installed applications on this device. There are few applications, but not a lot of them. When it comes to optimization, as I said earlier, Mi 10T right now has greatly optimized Mi UI version. Will that be the case after 6 months as well? I cannot really comment about that. Realme UI right now is very well optimized and it can become better with software updates, I feel, because Realme X7 Pro has not received any major software update as such, whereas Mi 10T has been in the market for quite some time now. So overall, UIs on both these devices are considerably cleaner as compared to their budget counterparts. But if I had to choose, I would go with the Realme UI. When it comes to a lot of features being there, Mi UI also has a lot of features and Realme UI also has a lot of features. There are some exclusive features in Realme UI and there are some exclusive features in Mi UI as well. Next up, let's talk about the cameras on these devices, and that's going to be maybe important factor for a lot of people. I have to say it outright first that Mi 10T has support for Gcam, whereas you cannot install Gcam on the Dimensity 1000 Plus powered Realme X7 Pro as of shooting this video at least. So that's an added advantage for Mi 10T right now. But when it comes to the regular stock camera application, which one performs better? I recently compared the Mi 10i against the Realme X7, and in that video I said that Realme X7 adds little bit of saturation, little bit of colors, and makes them look little bit poppy, and I personally like that. I did not say that Mi 10i clicks bad pictures. I just said that Mi 10i looks more natural. If you prefer that, then go with that. But over here, the thing is, it's going to be different. Mi 10T adds a little bit of saturation. Let's start with the building picture that we have clicked, and the sky clearly looks different on one picture, different on the other one. The building color looks different, but the important factor here is that the building color looks as it looks on the Mi 10T, but the sky looks like how it is on the Realme X7 Pro. Next up, let's talk about the ultra-wide angle camera sample of the same building, and this is where things are a little bit interesting. The sky color remains the same on both these devices, and that's a good thing. I mean, Realme X7 Pro had sky in different color earlier, and it's the same in this image as well. If we zoom into the Raheja Heights, then both of them have decent amount of details, but Mi 10T surprisingly has sharper image as compared to Realme X7 Pro. Now, next up, let's talk about the car that we have. Now, if we zoom in on the tire, Mi 10T has slightly more details as compared to Realme X7 Pro. Slightly more details. It's not like a day and night difference. It's just that Realme X7 Pro smoothens the image just a bit. If you zoom in, you realize that. Whereas Mi 10i or Mi 10T keeps those scratches on the vehicle, or let's say small marks, dents are kept basically. This is the ultra wide angle shot clicked from both these devices. And once again, if we zoom in on the car, I would say both of them have pretty good details. Next up, we have shot of another building from a different angle. And this picture was clicked to see how the performance is in shadows. And you can see that Mi 10T does not have a lot of details in shadows. I mean, this particular tree, if we focus on this leaf, then Realme X7 Pro's image looks better as compared to Mi 10T. Once again, the sky of the Mi 10T looks bluer than how it was. It is not this blue in Mumbai right now, at least. The same thing which was happening with the Realme X7 in the video. Next up, we have the ultra wide angle camera shot, and this is once again an interesting one. Once again, the sky is more blue on the Mi 10T, but if we look at the details in shadows with ultra wide angle camera, Realme X7 Pro kept those details more as compared to Mi 10T. Now, this is another shot captured with the normal camera, and once again, both these devices clicked a good picture in my opinion. In this particular, like when it comes to primary camera sensor, Mi 10T also keeps a lot of details when it comes to shadows. It's just that when it comes to ultra wide angle camera, Realme X7 Pro performs better. I personally found that both these devices clicked good picture over here, no issues whatsoever. Then we have our ROG figure. Very interesting results here. The same purple color that you can see in the video, we kept the figure here and we clicked the image. You can clearly see in the camera that this is not that brown, right? So this is how Mi 10T's picture looks. Very brown. And purple, very purple as compared to Realme X7 Pro. When it comes to the details, if we zoom in on the face of that ROG figure, Realme X7 Pro has clicked a sharper image, slightly sharper image as compared to Mi 10T. So in this particular image, I am going to say, I mean, it's difficult. As I said in my earlier video, I like saturated images, but I guess Mitten and I did it a little bit extra in this particular case. It was not that purple over here. You can see there is no purple thing here, but still Mitten T has purple background, very, very much purple. Now in this particular image of Sprayons, the colors, if we zoom in on the middle one, you can see that Mitten T has more details. I mean, the text looks sharper on the Mitten T as compared to Realme X7 Pro. And here are some extra sample shots that we shot with both these devices. And I guess that's pretty much it for the camera comparison of these devices. Which one is better? I have to say this here, Mitten T clicks saturated image. I mean, the software processing is designed in such a way that it adds little bit of extra saturation, little bit of punchiness in the image, whereas Realme X7 Pro does not do it yet. But with the software update, obviously Realme can add it, and I think they will add it, considering Realme devices usually have little bit of extra saturation, which I personally prefer as well. So in this particular camera test, you can be the judge, but Mitten T's images were the ones which I liked, as I have, you know my liking, and that's why I preferred Mitten T over the Realme X7 Pro. In the last video, I said I liked the Realme X7, and in this video, I'm saying I liked the Mitten T. So in the last video, I was paid by Realme, and in this video, I'm paid by Xiaomi. So much money. I am rich. Rich. I am not paid by anyone to do this comparison. If I am, I will tell you guys beforehand only. Next up, let's talk about the pricing, and that's the most important factor, and the confusion began because of pricing in my opinion. Mitten T was launched for 36,000 rupees and Realme X7 Pro is launched for 30,000 rupees. But Mitten T's pricing has dropped to 33,000 rupees. Not just that, in some sale, the pricing comes down to 30,000 rupees. There is some extra cashback or extra exchange offer. Like if you exchange 2,000 rupees device, then you get 3,000-4,000 rupees extra, some sort of that offer. So the effective pricing can come down to, let's say, 26,000 rupees, which is cheaper than Realme X7 Pro's pricing of 30,000 rupees and 2,000 rupees extra discount of, let's say, ICICI, which is 28,000 rupees. So that's why people are getting confused whether to go with Mitten T or Realme X7 Pro. And I think the final factor in deciding which one to go for is going to be the display quality, and that's why I kept it at the last, because everything else is really good on both these devices other than the speaker quality. Let's talk about that later. But display quality, 120Hz AMOLED screen against 144Hz LCD screen. If you ask me, I will not say, I will just say, I personally prefer 120Hz AMOLED screen of the Realme X7 Pro. If you prefer 144Hz LCD screen, I will not blame you. That's your choice. This is my choice. Is Realme X7 Pro's display much, much better as compared to LCD screen of this device? Yes, if you look at deep blacks, if you watch a lot of content, then Realme X7 Pro's display will look better. If you look at Mitten T's display from LCD display's point of view, this is one of the best LCD panels available in the market as well. 144Hz refresh rate against 120Hz refresh rate. Can you notice a difference? Yes, sometimes you can, sometimes you may not. It depends and it will vary from person to person. But I will not really say that just because it's 144Hz, go and buy this, because 120Hz AMOLED screen is more than enough in my opinion. So when it comes to display department, my choice is going to be Realme X7 Pro. You are free to decide yours. Once again, Mitten T has great display quality, great viewing angles, and display quality is not bad. It's just that AMOLED being AMOLED has its own advantages over LCD. You can always Google or search on YouTube AMOLED versus LCD and decide for yourself. Even if you go for Mitten T, I will not say that it's a bad choice. Obviously, why do I have to clarify? I clarify these small things, thinking about people commenting, oh, why do you say that AMOLED is better? LCD screen on Mitten T is really good. I'm not saying that it's bad. I'm just saying that I prefer AMOLED. That's my choice. I'm reviewing or comparing these devices from my point of view, and my point of view is that this one is better. The Realme X7 Pro basically. Next up, let's talk about the speaker quality, and this definitely surprised me. I was not expecting this. Both these devices have stereo speaker setup. I'll just play, my speaker is over here and the speakers are pointing to the mic basically. I'll just play the song from Mitten T. This is the Realme X7 Pro. Did you think you could keep us out? Shut the gates, forget us now. I'm saying I was surprised because I did not expect Realme X7 Pro to be this loud. Mi 10T speaker is actually very good. I enjoy listening to Mi 10T speaker, but Realme X7 Pro is not just louder, but it's slightly better sounding as compared to Mi 10T. Dolby Atmos is supported on the Realme X7 Pro, so that might be the reason for it being louder and still being a better quality speaker as compared to Mi 10T. Both these devices do not have a headphone jack, they do not have a memory card slot, they simply have a single SIM tray which can accommodate two SIM cards. Dual 4G, dual Wi-Fi is obviously supported on both these devices. These are flagship processors, so that's supported. Next up, let's talk about gaming, and this is where things are really interesting. Snapdragon 865 is a really good gaming processor. But Dimensity 1000 Plus is not a bad processor, but right now PUBG Mobile does not support 90fps option on the Realme X7 Pro, so we were not able to test how the device will perform at 90fps. But for 60fps option, I would say the Realme X7 Pro performs good at best. Right now, if PUBG Mobile is your priority, then Mi 10T is much better as compared to Realme X7 Pro. It has 90fps option, plus it gives stable 90fps. Right now, at least in the game. With software updates, that may change with the Realme X7 Pro. But for gaming, and if we are talking about Snapdragon processors, then they have always been good. It does not overheat with the Realme X7 Pro, and it does not overheat on the Mi 10T as well. So for now, for PUBG Mobile gaming, Mi 10T is going to be my primary choice. Overall, in general, if you play other games like Call of Duty, if you play Clash of Clans and all those games which support 120Hz or 144Hz refresh rate, then both these devices will handle them perfectly. You do not need to worry about gaming section, at least on both these devices. And I guess that's pretty much it. Let's talk about some extra points that both these devices have. First one, Mi 10T has an IR blaster sensor, which was quite surprising, and I like that IR blaster sensor very much. You can control TV, remote, AC, everything. The Realme X7 Pro does not have anything. I personally feel Realme X7 Pro's primary advantage is going to be its smaller size, less weight. Mi 10T's advantage is going to be being a Snapdragon device, having Gcam support, and having slightly better gaming performance in PUBG Mobile, at least as of shooting this video. I talked about all the other points in this video, so you can decide your preferences and decide which one to go for. If you still have any more doubt sessions or queries regarding this video, you can comment down below, like this video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and you can also tweet it to me at @dhanj_tech. The link is present in the description box below. So yeah, thank you guys. Thank you for watching.